Hey everyone, Bea here. In the previous lesson, we learned how living things use aerobic cellular respiration to convert chemical potential energy in glucose into the energy currency ATP. We saw how oxygen is the electron acceptor at the end of the electron transport chain, the step where the bulk of ATP is produced. Without oxygen, most of the ATP from cellular respiration cannot be made. So, what if oxygen isn't present? Are there any alternative methods for cells to break down fuel molecules and form ATP? It turns out there are. Let's take a closer look. By the end of this lesson, you'll be able to describe lactic acid fermentation, alcoholic fermentation, and anaerobic respiration. Let's begin with a process called lactic acid fermentation. The first step of lactic acid fermentation is something we're already familiar with, glycolysis. Recall that glycolysis was the first step in cellular respiration. It does not require oxygen, so glycolysis can occur even when no oxygen is present. As we saw last time, glycolysis splits one glucose into two pyruvate, produces a gain of 2 ATP, and converts 2 NAD+ into 2 NADH. Do you remember what NADH does? It carries electrons. During aerobic cellular respiration, NADH donates its electrons to the electron transport chain, turning back into NAD+ in the process. The NAD+ then return to glycolysis to accept more electrons. It's sort of like a battery that gets recharged over and over again. But in fermentation, there is no electron transport chain, so NADH needs somewhere else to drop off its electrons so it can be recycled for glycolysis. We're in luck because it turns out that pyruvate can accept electrons from NADH, allowing NADH to turn back into NAD+. In the process of accepting electrons, the two pyruvate react and turn into two new molecules called lactic acid, hence the name lactic acid fermentation. So, which cell types perform lactic acid fermentation in the absence of oxygen? Animal muscle cells can, and that includes our muscles. When a human or other animal is exerting themselves, for example, while running, and their cells are deprived of oxygen, muscle cells can temporarily use lactic acid fermentation to meet their energy needs. Cells only get 2 ATP per glucose during fermentation compared to roughly 36 from aerobic cellular respiration. Fermentation is a much less efficient way to produce ATP, but it's better than nothing in a pinch. Additionally, the remaining potential energy in the lactic acid molecules isn't wasted. They can be converted back into pyruvate when oxygen becomes available, and then go through full aerobic respiration. Or lactic acid may be transported by the bloodstream to the liver, where it can be converted back into glucose and used for respiration. Scientists used to think that lactic acid was a waste product in our muscles and was responsible for muscle soreness during exercise. However, a growing body of evidence suggests that is not true. More recent research suggests that lactic acid is an important energy molecule in our bodies at all times, not just during exercise. More research is needed to understand the role that lactic acid fermentation plays in our bodies. Lactic acid fermentation is not the only type of fermentation in the living world. Some cells perform a different process called alcoholic fermentation in absence of oxygen. Like lactic acid fermentation, alcoholic fermentation begins with glycolysis, which produces 2-ATP. And once again, NADH needs somewhere to donate its electrons so it can be recycled as NAD+. In this case, the electrons are used as two pyruvate molecules react to form two molecules of ethanol, a type of alcohol. Two carbon dioxide molecules are also released in the process. In both types of fermentation, the ability of NAD+ and NADP to continuously recycle is what allows the process to continue squeezing a couple of ATP out of each glucose molecule. The cells in our bodies do not perform alcoholic fermentation, but one example of an organism that does is yeast, a category of single-celled fungi. Yeast ferment sugars through alcoholic fermentation. In fact, this is how beverages like beer and wine are made. Yeast is added to either grains or fruit, which both contain sugar produced through photosynthesis. The yeast ferments the sugars to create ATP for itself, producing alcohol and carbon dioxide in the process. Yeast is also used in baking as an addition to some bread doughs. As yeast ferments sugar in the dough, carbon dioxide is released. The carbon dioxide gas creates air pockets inside the dough and makes it rise. Alcohol is also produced, but most of it evaporates during baking, leaving very little alcohol in the final product. We have one more type of oxygen-free ATP production to discuss. It's not technically a form of fermentation, rather it's called anaerobic respiration. As its name suggests, the process is similar to the aerobic respiration we learned about last time, with an important difference. Instead of using oxygen as the final electron acceptor in the electron transport chain, anaerobic respiration uses a different molecule for the same purpose. Substitutes include sulfate, nitrate, and sulfur. Anaerobic respiration is used by some bacteria living in environments where oxygen is scarce, for example, inside the intestine of other organisms. Anaerobic respiration is also used by some archaea, another category of single-celled organisms. Archaea tend to live in extreme environments, for example, near hydrothermal vents. We'll learn more about these organisms in a later unit. For now, all we need to know is that some forms of life can perform anaerobic cellular respiration by substituting something else for oxygen. Some bacteria and archaea can switch between aerobic and anaerobic methods of producing ATP. Others can only perform anaerobic respiration. In fact, oxygen is toxic to some organisms and will kill them if they are exposed. It's wild to think that a substance which is so essential for our survival is deadly to others. We now know that lactic acid fermentation produces lactic acid and generates 2 ATP per glucose. Alcoholic fermentation produces ethanol and carbon dioxide and generates 2 ATP per glucose. And anaerobic respiration substitutes other molecules for oxygen in the electron transport chain. We've now learned about aerobic cellular respiration, which requires oxygen, and fermentation, which does not require oxygen. Both these processes allow the potential energy in fuel molecules to be converted to usable ATP. They are part of the larger set of reactions that make up metabolism. Next time, we'll learn more about the many chemical reactions which work together to keep living things alive. Until then, remember, biology is more than just science, it's the way of life. Hey!